Hi, I would like to show you how to analyze the topology of SARS-CoV-2 using PureSec TMR, an R package, on the Groningen Peregrine computer cluster. It's part of the university. So to do that, we'll be creating a script to do that. We'll copy it to the cluster. Then we're going to run the script in an antisocial way. So I'll also interrupt it. Then we'll copy another script to the cluster to run it in a social way. That's what we'll be doing that. And then we'll copy back our results to our local computer. So let's get started. First, we need to create a script. And what does that script do? Well, at the website of PureSec TMR, there's a script here to analyze the topology of SARS-CoV-2. And this is the topology it predicts. Well, we're going to copy that script to a file, let's call it here. And there will be a modification, actually there will be two. Because we also add to the script that it installs the package, and also it installs PureSec TM, which is the program it calls. So we're going to add those two lines at the top. So first it installs the package, then it installs what the package is calling. Then library, here it loads the proteome, predicts the topology, simplify protein names, and here it plots. Well, we can't do plotting on the cluster, we can, but not here. We won't do it here. Instead, we're going to do reader write CSV x equals, I think to save to CSV, it's topology, the thing you want to save, and a file name, SARS-CoV-2.topology. Now, well, let's call it something like this, topology.cc. It will be a comma separated file. We won't plot the topology, so this is the file we'll be using. And I'm going to call it script.r, very brilliant name. Alright, so we have a script that installs the library, installs the tool it's calling, calls it, gets the proteome, predicts the topology, simplifies the protein names, and saves it to file. Great, that's done. Closing this one. Now we need to copy it to the cluster. To do that, I'll be using a terminal, but you can use anything you want. So I have the script in my local folder, and I'm going to scopy the script to my username at peregrine.hpc.rug.nl:\home/my-number-again. There. I'm going to copy it to my home folder. And with SCP you can do that. I'll type in my password. And it's copied to my home folder. Of course you can use MobileXterm or FileZilla, something like that. Alright, now we're going to run it on the cluster. Well, then we also need to go onto the cluster. shp-nip@peregrine.hpc-high-performance-computing@rug.nl. So I'm on the cluster now. You can see it. There's a Peregrine at the top. This is my stuff. There's Hello Kitty doing work, telling me what to do, or how much the cluster loves me. That's all fine and dandy. Let's do an ls. Yeah. So our script is here. Let's check, we're going to cat the script. Great, works. Well, now we're going to run the script in an antisocial way. So we want to run R, and we can't because the command's not found. That's because the cluster only allows you to run certain programs that you've loaded. R is a module. If you load that module, then you can run R. Actually, I'm not going to run R because I'm not going to type the local things. I'm just going to run the script. You can do that with R script, script R. Now it's running. So for me, it says that it's already updated and installed, so that's great. Actually, it quits my script. Also, I'm going to remove that You can use nano on the Peregrine cluster to edit a script. So I've already have these installed, so I'm going to comment them out with a hashtag or sharp or a pound. Exit, save, yes. And now I can run my script. So it's running now. And while this is running, we're going to take a look at the next step. We're going to copy a file to the cluster because now we're running it in an antisocial way. This is antisocial because we are now at the login node, which is the node that all people use to start their jobs. So using it with some intensive process like this is very antisocial. I just show it here for demonstration purposes. And I normally never do this. So next step, there's a file. We're going to copy a file called run rscript to cluster. Well, I know where that file is. It's on the Peregrine GitHub, /peregrine, in the folder called scripts. There's a script called run rscript. There it is. And it's a very simple script. It only loads R but from the module. It says what it's going to do, and then it calls rscript. This is what we just did, rscript on the arguments you give it. So I'm just going to save it. Actually, I know where it is. Let's save it locally. Save file as, save page as. Run rscript in my home folder, and there it is. So now we have it at our local computer. I'm first going to copy it as copy. Run rscript. Perhaps it's somewhere in my history. No, it's not. Run rscript to p22 and peregrine. Dot hpc dot rug dot nl home slash p298. So here we copy the script to the Peregrine cluster. That's great. Now going back to the Peregrine cluster, you can see it in my prompt. Our antisocial script has ran. We can see that because it saves the results as this file. And with cat we can see the file content. So here is the topology of our virus. But now we're going to do something different because we have just copied the file to the folder. Now we're going to run our rscript on the cluster in a social way. So, and for that we're going to use sbatch. Sbatch means submit a batch script. In this case, run rscript. And what rscript do we want to run? Script. So that means that in this way, it will run our script in a social way. So it takes a bit longer than usually. But what it's doing, it will submit the job to a queue. And I think that something's wrong with the queue, because already during startup, something was shown to be wrong with the queue. Well, if this is done, let's take a look, but let's assume it's done with sq-$user, I think. sq-u$user. It shows you the job queue for your jobs. So would my script be running, which I think it doesn't, it will show me that my script is running. And it will take approximately 10 minutes, a couple of minutes, like we've just seen when we ran it in the antisocial way. So there's something wrong with the queue today, that's fine. But we've ran the script on the cluster in a social way. Now we're going to copy back the results to our local computer because perhaps that's what we like. So let's the results are called SARS-CoV-2 topology. I'm going to copy that name. I'm going back to my computer by exiting the cluster, and I'm going to copy the file sp-zip at peregrine.highperformancecomputing.rexuniversitegroningen.home/p2198/this-file to here. It asks me for my password again. And now we have this result file on our computer, and we can open it, for example, with LibreOffice or whatever you like. And it's a table, so this definitely makes sense. that it parses it to these weird things does not make sense. Like, it's very helpful in normal situations, but in this case it's not. I'm not gonna save it. I like to use cat. And all right, so that's what I wanted to show, and I wish you a very good day. Bye.